What's up everybody, it's Sean here, and I'm here today to give you guys a review of the Jordan Airship PESP in this tech gray colorway. Today's video is brought to you by Quality. Quality is a Montreal-based streetwear brand, and it's a brand that I've been personally wearing for years now. Recently, they just launched their Spring and Summer 2023 line, which includes a ton of basics as well as statement pieces. So regardless of your style, whether you're someone that prefers more plain or basic looking clothes, or if you're someone that likes louder prints, you're gonna find there's something for everyone. So whether you're looking for t-shirts, tank tops, sweaters, cardigans, denim or shorts, or anything in between, Quality will have you covered. So I'll link their website, their social media, all that good stuff down below. So be sure to check them out and be sure to tell them that I sent you. So Nike continues to really push the Airship silhouette, and this is the latest colorway to drop. Releasing on June 7th, these released for a price of $140 US or $180 here in Canada. And the official colorway for this shoe is Summit White, Gunsmoke, and Tech Gray. So this colorway of the Airship looks very similar to the neutral gray or natural gray Air Jordan 185. And given the similarities between the Air Jordan 1 and the Airship, I can see why a lot of people who already own those Jordan 1s decided to pass on this shoe. But I gotta say, I was very impressed with these once I got them in person. First things first though, here's a quick look at the box. So unlike the past Airship releases that came in that retro styled box, this one instead comes in this all black cardboard box, and we have Nike branding on the very top done in the shiny finish. And as far as the shoe goes, so the upper of the shoe is predominantly constructed out of the smooth Summit White colored leather. So on the toe box, we have these perforations, and overlaid on top of this and surrounding the front toe cap, we have another layer of that same white leather. So to me, as far as a Jordan or Nike product goes, I thought this leather that they used was very high quality, and I was very impressed with this. So you can see that same leather covers the eyelets of the shoe, as well as underneath this on the entire mid panel as well. And then overlaid on top of this, we have this Nike swoosh, which is constructed out of a shaggy gray colored suede. And surrounding the top collar area of the shoe, we have that same long haired suede, which circles around the heel also. And then embroidered in the center at the very top of the heel, we have Nike Air branding done in this darker gray color, and we have another single strip of white leather which runs down the center. As far as the laces go, so these come with two different lace options. The standard default lace and the one that I prefer are these normal flat style laces in white. But they also give you a secondary gray colored lace if you want to give the shoe a little bit more pop and a little bit more contrast. Underneath this, we have this retro looking tongue, which is constructed out of this aged looking nylon, which has a bit of an orangey reddish tint to it. And on the very top, we have this tag with Nike Air branding woven in this dark gray color. The interior of the shoe is lightly padded, and it's covered in this gray colored nylon, which has a silky smooth finish to the touch. And just like any other Nike Airship, we have the size of the shoe pressed onto the collar, giving it that retro feel and look. And then taking a look at the insoles, so these come with a polyurethane foam midsole. It's finished in a white colored textile on the top, and we have the Jumpman logo pressed on the heel in gray. So the upper of the Airship sits atop this solid rubber cupsole, which more or less matches the color of the upper of the shoe. And encased within this midsole but not visible to the eye, we do have a heel air unit for cushioning and impact protection. And then finally, turning this pair over to the bottom, this outsole is constructed out of a dark gray colored rubber. Just like any other Airship, we have the circular pivot point on the forefoot just like an Air Jordan 1, along with this tilted Nike logo found right in the middle. So that breaks down the look and the construction of this pair. And for those wondering about sizing, to me these fit like any other Airship that I've personally tried on. So I got these in my true size, which is a size 10. My foot measures as a true size 10, slightly on the wider side, and a size 10 in the Airship fits me perfectly from a length perspective, but it is a little bit snug width-wise, but not enough that I'd want to go up to a 10.5. So I feel like the Airship feels ever so slightly more snug than a Air Jordan 1 High OG. So I feel like if you have a really, really wide foot, you might want to consider going up a half size for the Airship. But for a narrow, normal, or even a slightly wide footer, true to size should be okay. But long story short, I'd stick with your normal Air Jordan 1 size, and I feel like it should be okay for your foot. Moving on to the comfort, so honestly, the Airship more or less feels like an Air Jordan 1. This is a shoe from 1984, so the technology is very outdated. It's gonna feel pretty firm, flat, and low to the ground, and there's not too much from a softness and stepping comfort perspective. However, the insole that's provided is fairly thick, so you can feel some of that foam, especially underneath the heel. But when you compare the Airship to a modern day shoe, obviously it's not gonna have that same level of comfort. But if you have your expectations in line, I feel like this shoe will be perfectly fine for an everyday casual use shoe, assuming you're not expecting it to be extremely soft and cushiony. Finally, in terms of the overall quality and craftsmanship, so like I mentioned earlier on in the review, I was very impressed with this leather. This is not an overly tumbled and overly soft leather, but quality-wise, to me at least, I'm not a leather expert, but from the eye test, it seemed like it was good quality. You run your fingers across it, you can see those natural leather grains, which is sometimes kind of a rarity when it comes to Jordan and Nike products. And same thing with the suede, this felt like a nice thick cut of genuine suede. So I was very impressed with the overall materials on this shoe. And same thing with the craftsmanship, honestly my pair was pretty flawless. The stitch job was really nice, there was minimal glue stains on this shoe, and there was no issues with the paint whatsoever. So repeating myself again, I was very happy and extremely impressed with these once I took them out of the box and saw them in real life. So with all that out of the way, now let's toss on these Airships, I'll lace them up and I'll show you guys how these look. If you're in the market for a neutral looking shoe with that retro flair, and you don't necessarily want to wear an Air Jordan 1 for example, or a Dunk, I think this is a very, very solid alternative. The Airship still doesn't have that super high level of hype, which is a great thing for those of us who want to buy shoes and not overpay for them. And while this still has a similar flavor to those other 80s basketball sneakers from Nike, the Airship currently is still more of that niche silhouette. So if you're one of those people that just doesn't like wearing what everyone else has on foot, then I think this is a shoe that makes sense for you to pick up. So let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about this Jordan Airship in this tech gray color? What are your overall thoughts on the colorway? And in general, are you a fan of the Nike Airship? Is it not really your thing? Either way, drop a comment down below and let's talk about this shoe. If you guys like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. You can follow me on Instagram at esco8, follow my Twitter account at sean.go, and visit my website at seango.ca. So until next time, thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review and hopefully it helped you in some way. And I'll catch you guys all in my next video.